But in October, that supersonic dream came to an end. In the latest in our series looking back at the year, Graham Satchell has been talking to Concorde's last commercial pilot, Captain Mike Bannister.
I'm very lucky. I'm one of those folks that knew what I wanted to do from the age of seven. And I can remember to this day sitting on the beach in Bournemouth and looking up, seeing this little aeroplane flying over to the continent and thinking with the precociousness of a seven-year-old, that's what I want to do, I want to be a pilot.
Mike Bannister realised his childhood dream. He went to pilot school and then this happened.
Just seconds to go after all this long, long wait.
It was history in the making and a moment that would change Mike's life forever.
So I was watching a little black and white television in the study room and I saw the first flight of the British constructed Concorde and thought, that's what I want to do. I want to be a Concorde pilot.
She flies. Concorde flies at last.
I knew from the very first flight that I took that this is what I wanted to do. This was almost a vocation rather than a career.
Come fly with me. Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar.
Was it fun to fly?
Oh, fantastic fun to fly. Absolutely fabulous. Rather like a sports car compared to a truck. You could actually fly the aeroplane with your fingertips throughout the entire regime, from takeoff through climb, acceleration, supersonic flight, descent, deceleration and landing.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me.
Mike Bannister piloted Concorde for 26 years, pretty much her whole commercial life. He's got a logbook full of memories. The highlight, an extraordinary flypast for the Queen's Golden Jubilee.
When we flew in formation with the Red Arrows down the Mall, something came as a surprise. What I didn't expect was to see a million plus people. I've never seen a million people before. No idea what that looks like. And to see them cheering and waving, and to see Her Majesty on the balcony, because she was wearing this bright orange-red costume, you could quite clearly see her. I mean, that to me was perhaps the highlight of my Concorde career.
We're going to travel across the Atlantic at twice the speed of sound, faster than a rifle bullet, 23 miles every minute. We're going to travel so fast, we're moving faster than the Earth rotates. And the world will be watching us.
You're beautiful, that's for sure. Never, ever fade.
October the 24th, Concorde's last commercial flight. In the end, it was the money that did for Concorde. £8,000 for a return ticket to New York. She was just too expensive to fly.
All the best for your approach. It's been a pleasure to serve you over the last 30 years.
It's much appreciated, and we always like coming back to London.
With those words, Mike Bannister brought Concorde down for the last time, and the supersonic dream came to an end.
When I told my daughter Amy, who at the time was nine, about the retirement of Concorde, you know, she burst into tears saying, but Daddy, I wanted to be a Concorde pilot. I have to say, the next day when I went home, she'd resolved that in her own mind and said, I've made my mind up, Daddy, I'm going to design the next generation of supersonic airliners so I can fly those. I can't imagine Amy saying to her children in years to come, remember when Granddad crossed the Atlantic in 3 hours, now it always takes 8.5.
Unforgettable, that's what you are.
You obviously have to be a very calm man to be a pilot of a supersonic plane. But, you'll miss flying that, won't you?
Oh, I will. And I think today is perhaps the first time I've started talking about Concorde in the past tense. Whatever happens, I will carry on flying in one shape or form or another, because the spark that attracted me right in the very few first moments when I was seven is still there.
Thinks that I am unforgettable too.